Today in Interculture, we're talking about the amazing Amsterdam Dance Event. It was held in October and was a great success again.
Now it's time to look back and ask one of our vloggers, Juan Buis, how he experienced the event. He was there as a music reporter and he spoke to a lot of DJs backstage. Hi, Juan.
Hey, what's up?
Hey, so did you spot any interesting trends at the ADE?
Well, the main trend I spotted was just EDM, electronic dance music, getting bigger. That's really one of the main genres getting big right now. But in general, I saw that the electronic scene is really broad. There are so many different kinds of electronic music. It's hard to keep an eye on every one of them.
And when you have to say a DJ, which artist should we definitely keep an eye on?
Well, for electronic dance music, for EDM, I think it's Martin Garrix. It's this 18-year-old kid who just got the fourth spot on the DJ Mag Top 100 DJ list. But other than that, I really think you should keep a look on for Falco Benz, who makes really good synth pop music. He's a producer, he's a DJ, and he's from the Netherlands as well.
And with all those DJs, is there a lot of sex, drugs, rock and roll? I mean, you can be honest now.
Of course, it was backstage a lot. You meet a lot of DJs, you meet a lot of cool, interesting people. But mainly, all of those people are just very nice, decent people with a very professional attitude. So you don't see too much champagne, really.
So what was the craziest thing that you have experienced during your interviews?
There was this really crazy moment backstage at Awakenings when I got to meet Wolter Kroes, which is a Dutch local hero. That was pretty cool, but like the main, during the interview, the crazy thing that happened was just me being able to talk to Hans Zimmer, one of the guys that made, well, like 40% of all film music.
Wow.
I think exists. That was for me the craziest thing
to experience. Amazing, man. Thanks a lot and see you next year. Ciao.
Thank you.